Hello. Basically, I'd like to make a postulate. As we know, there is quite a lot of controversy over the whole so-called UFO subject. And as a science student, I have to admit, I myself am a little skeptical, being fully aware of the laws of physics. However, there were various postulates even back in the 1970s, and Carl Sagan did say that the postulated Bussard ramjet might have allowed for a multi-generational colony ship for humans to arrive at some faraway planet. However, I have a suspicion, again based on Carl Sagan's work, as a way that we could test for the so-called UFO phenomena. If an advanced race had that capability for interstellar, they probably would have had fairly fast interplanetary craft as well. Now think about this. In one of his pieces, Carl Sagan stated that there was the possibility that that either there could be multiple millions of species all around us, or there could be a few scattered out throughout time, courtesy of them not living beyond the atomic age. Well, one of the other things that is known is the fact that industrial society requires a large amount of resources to be able to, survive. There requires, there's obviously the life support needed to support your species, your population. But metals and other stuff like that are metals, silicates, what have you, are all necessary at some level or other to make industrial equipment. So, here's what happens. Say, for example, several thousand years ago, or maybe even longer, some extra—I mean, we already know of a planet about 581 light years from here called Cica 581c. This is an extraterrestrial, this is a what scientists believe to be an Earth-like planet. Now, what if it was actually populated? And that rather than just us, what if there was another civilization beforehand there who had populated and had and even designed the Bussard ramjet? But then they ran out of resources in their own asteroid belt, or asteroid belts plural. The solar systems only have so much in resources. They see an Earth-like planet over here. It's possible that they could have gotten a series of fleet of Bussard ramjet-type spacecraft that flew here a few thousand years ago before we could even get anywhere. Now, here's the thing. There is one, maybe two good places in our solar system which are relatively easy to hide in because of the fact that we've only sent one or two satellites through that area. One of which is the Mars-Jupiter asteroid belt, the same one that is necessary for us to colonize if we want to maintain industrial society for any prolonged period of time. And, given the current way we're using up resources, that we're probably going to need to be up there in the next 20 to 30 years. So here's my way that I propose that we test for extraterrestrials. Simple. We colonize the asteroid belt, and we also put powerful telescopes on our own, in addition to whatever equipment we need for spectrographic readings and stuff, to be able to know what resources each asteroid has. If the bulk of the human race are colonizing 2 million asteroids, and if extraterrestrials are in them, sooner or later, they will have to eventually get caught. They can't move away because they need the resource base to maintain their industrial society. So, here's my proposition. For that remaining 10% of UFO phenomena that can't be explained, they are either A, natural phenomena, or B, extraterrestrials. But the bottom line is, those that we're not going to know until we actually colonize the asteroid belt or start seriously looking at it. So, in my book, one more, let's shelve this whole issue about whether extraterrestrials are there or not. And here's the other postulate to my phenomena. If that race is theoretically fairly advanced, they would have probably gone through a similar stage where one group had colonized another colony, another continent, and they probably would have had something equivalent of like where the white people pay $25 to the natives to kick them off their land. So they probably know that that's not smart. So, seeing a sentient race here, they probably would have decided to get to the asteroid belt before we did, strip mine it, and move on. But since the asteroid belt hasn't been strip mined and there's been 2 million asteroids, they probably was either a small group, which might have been there and died out, or something else. But the bottom line is, those, they would not have communicated, and to skeptics, why would they have not communicated with our fellow skeptics? Why would they have not communicated with our race? Simply because of the fact that we are a lesser advanced species, and they would have known not to, interfere with us, much like we've learned better not to interfere with First Nations groups anymore. Because we learned from our mistakes, and hopefully so did they. So, yeah, that's my hope. Anyway, that's my thought on it. Let's shelve the whole issue on extraterrestrial spacecraft or what have you until we can get better powerful telescopes, or we can train the ones that we already have looking out at the asteroid belt and, checking for radio emissions or other stuff like that, Or, like, let's send radar out to the asteroid belt and see if there's any metallic craft out there, or something like that. Like, let's if that's the easiest way, it's relatively easy. Just train them on the asteroid belt, train them on the Jupiter's moons, and or go out there and colonize, and sooner or later, if there's anything there, we'll find it. So it's not really important. Let's shelve the issue. Anyway, that's my bottom line. On another note, it is necessary to colonize the asteroid belt, largely for a couple of reasons. One of which is that if we don't do anything about it, we are going to lose out of resources like iron, copper, nickel, aluminum, that sort of thing. Eros, a typical asteroid. I'm going to put the website up here over in the right hand side, so this way you can go take a look at the bibliography. But like I said, Space Studies Institute, Stephen Hawking, even NASA is saying that we have to get off planet or we go bust. So, what can I say? Space colonization is necessary for our society. And as for UFOs, you know, if there are aliens out there, all the more reason to start colonizing the asteroid belt before they get too much of our resources. We're the sentient race in this solar system. Those are our legitimate right. Anyway, that's just my thought on it. Let me know if you see any flaws in the idea. It might be possible, and I'm just simply saying it might be a way to test for it. Anyway, let me know what you think, and do please drop comments below. And more importantly, read the website in the right-hand side here. And don't forget to read the bibliography, and then get back to me on the Cosmocratic bit. I'll be putting up more videos on space colonization in greater detail in the next little while. In the meantime, toodles!